On February 9, 1969, Boeing Company tested its biggest corporate gamble, the Boeing 747 jet, nearly bankrupting the company in order to fill a request from Pan American Airlines to build the world's biggest jetliner. The successful launching of the Boeing 747 revolutionized commercial air travel, making intercontinental travel accessible and affordable to the middle class. The resulting increase in worldwide travel was a catalyst of globalization. The jumbo jet was instrumental in making the world flat. On January 15, 1970, First Lady Pat Nixon christened Pan Am's first 747, the Clipper Victor, at Washington's Dulles International Airport. The 747 then was scheduled to take its first revenue flight on Pan Am's capital route from Washington, D.C. to London's Heathrow International Airport. However, the 747's commercial introduction was not a smooth one. The flight was originally scheduled for the evening of January 21st, but engine overheating canceled the flight and delayed the next day's flight by 6 hours. Despite the 747's turbulent introduction, the public was excited to fly the new jumbo jet.
Jet travel was still something of a novelty for people,
says Richard Aboulafia, who is an analyst at Teal Group in Virginia, which analyzes data from the aviation and defense industry. He himself is an expert on the Boeing 747's development and introduction into commercial aviation.
Not further, so people could fly more direct routes, more point-to-point travel. So in general, I think they were quite enthusiastic. And the initial adapters, Pan Am, of course, was the first user. At that first moment, they decided to make things look as good as possible on the, in the interior. So there were a lot of luxurious features. There was a piano lounge, I believe, on a couple of initial planes. Back then, seats were bigger. In general, it was quite a grand affair to travel on the 747.
Prior to the 747's release, airlines like Pan Am and Eastern Airways operated small 707s and DC-8s on their transatlantic flights. Flights in these small airplanes were loud, cramped, and rough. The seats were also limited and airfares were high. Therefore, only businessmen and the wealthy could fly. Families and tourists rarely flew.
Before the 747, it was a far more elite thing for people to travel internationally.
However, the 747, with its 452-person capacity, significantly lowered the operating cost per seat and therefore airfares were lowered.
The 747 made it basically more of a middle-class phenomenon. And I remember quite well my first international flight back in the 1970s, and it was on a 747. And before that, I probably couldn't have afforded it, or it would have been a once or twice a lifetime sort of affair. But it really brought the price down and made it more accessible for most people because of its fuel efficiency and its better operating economics.
Due to the 747 size, it could carry more passengers for about 30% less money, making air travel more affordable. Between 1975 and 1981, the airline fare for international flights went down almost 25%. The average airline fare between Chicago and Paris was about $105, the equivalent of $248 today. Families and tourists could now afford to fly internationally.
Well, it certainly ushered in, or helped usher in, the age of mass tourism. All of a sudden, you have a plane that can carry 400 people. Before that, of course, it was a 707 that did these routes, or before that, Super Constellations and other large piston aircraft. So all of a sudden, you had three to four times as many people able to fly.
In the times before deregulation, there were no competing airfares. If the price was $120 on one airline, it was $120 on all airlines. Therefore, airlines tried to win over customers with their service on board. Pan Am offered first-class customers a piano bar on the 747. British Airways invested in a similar bar, too. All passengers on the airplane were served hot meals on China, served by pretty young flight attendants.
Yeah.
The glory days of jet travel lasted only a few years. In 1978, the Deregulation Act was passed and made airlines have to fend for themselves. The airlines, to save money, cut services to its passengers. Meals and piano bars were the first to go. The 747 was then stuffed with seats so the airlines could make as much money as they could on a single flight. Still, the 747 has been the most successful selling plane in history. To date, over 1,427 747s have been sold, and the 747 has logged over 42 billion nautical miles, over 101,500 trips to the moon. Over its 42-year career, the 747 has carried over 3.5 billion people. The 747 has literally made the world smaller. Countries and destinations one thought impossible to reach are just a few hours away.
You're able to fly more direct routes. You can get people to where they're going faster without having to stop somewhere. And if you look at the 747-400 that came online in 1989, that was the first nonstop plane, basically U.S. to, say, Hong Kong and many other Pacific destinations. And it became far more economically efficient to fly, say, to China as a result of this aircraft. That was transformative. It really did bring people closer together.
The 747 allowed people to travel outside of their borders and experience and discover the outside world, which helped bring people together.
Now, before the 747, you had small numbers of tourists and, frankly, most other people who flew internationally that brought countries together were either soldiers or missionaries and diplomats, not a whole large cross-section of the country. When you had planes like the 747 bringing people abroad, you had a larger number of Americans and Europeans and anyone else who used the plane going outside the country, meeting other people, seeing how other people lived, and, of course, bringing those ideas home. So in a lot of ways, that really did help bring the world closer together and teach people that the world outside their borders wasn't such a scary place.
In 2008, over 58 million people flew in the JFK's international terminal from around the world. Every night, over 8,000 flights crisscross the Atlantic Ocean between North America and Europe. And every day, over 20,000 people arrive into our major airports from different countries. The 747 has literally made the world smaller. The 747 has redefined air travel, made it possible for families to visit one another, businessmen and women to attend meetings in foreign countries, and allowing cargo and people to travel all around the world.